I want you to think back. Back to the early days of the 2000s. Anime, at least in the United States, was finally becoming more widely available. TV programming blocks, like Toonami and Adult Swim on Cartoon Network, were the lesser known, but still a gateway into the world of anime for me, Anime Unleashed, which ran on Tech TV, were widening the audience for a very niche entertainment product. Myself, like so many others at my age, were introduced into countless different anime in the era which, whether we knew it or not, would become formative moments in our entertainment consuming lives. Running around with cousins pretending to shoot spirit guns at one another because seeing Yusuke do it in the dark tournament was like the coolest thing, or pretending my crappy above ground pool in my backyard was the well portal to Inuyasha's feudal Japan, were all in a day's work for 11-year-old me. I'm sure you have some equally cringeworthy moments stuck in the back of your brain somewhere. This trip down memory lane comes from that fact. The fact that if you're watching this video, chances are you're still an anime fan. And many of us have a show that so affected us, it caused us to take some sort of action. Because I want you to be in the right mindset of what it was like for watching Fooly Cooly for the first time for me, and why it still means so much for me today. But I want to see if I can make you see it in a lens you might have forgotten the first time you watch it. Also, a lot of this is anecdotal, but I'm sure it'll apply to you too. For the uninitiated, Fooly Cooly, or as it's often stylized, FLCL, is a 6-episode OVA made in tandem by Studio Gainax and Production IG. And let's face it, the pillars deserve a ridiculous amount of credit for the impact the show had. It started its run in 2000 and made it over to the US in 2003 on Adult Swim. It played a few times here or there over the years until last year in 2017 when two follow-up series were announced, Fooly Cooly Progressive and Fooly Cooly Alternative. The show met with initial popularity and has since gained a large cult following ever since. As of the making of this video, it's available on Hulu, Funimation, and iTunes to watch legally with subscriptions, and it runs just over 2 hours in total, so it's perfect for a binge. None of that was even a thought in my head the first time I saw Fooly Cooly. The show was strange, incoherent, and kind of funny sometimes, but I was transfixed. It didn't seem to make any sense. I had no idea what was going on, but I knew I liked it. We laughed at the nonsense on the screen. The cat's meow sounded like a cow's moo, and there was slapstick humor about, and hey, even the music was kind of catchy, but we couldn't really understand the lyrics. But there was a weird sort of comfort in the insanity that the show presented that I really latched onto. At the tender age of 11 or so, few things did make sense in my world. And to see someone at my age, even though he was animated, go through stuff way crazier than I was at that time gave me a great deal of comfort. I know it sounds a bit hackneyed at this point, but that's the truth. This is where Fooly Cooly's greatest strength lies, Naota and his ability to connect to an audience. Naota is a shit. Simple as that. Naota's a 12-year-old boy who's constantly moody and never happy with the world around him or his place in it. He's getting closer to his teens and trying his hardest to leave behind his childlike view in the world. But things seldom seem to work out that way. Childhood tendencies, tastes, and views,
they try their damnedest to hang on as we age, no matter what we try to do to hide them.
As we've all aged into our 20s and 30s, I'm sure all of us can find some 12-year-old cousin or neighbor kid and look at them and think, wow, that kid's a little shit. Good thing I was never like that. Now, I can only speak for myself here in saying that, yes, I was a little shit. Very few things in my life were certain at that point. I was attempting to eschew my childlike ways and try to become more adult, which led to me not being the best person to a lot of people I should have been nicer to. I'm sure a lot of us can say the same thing. This is why the audience connects to Naota on such a deep level throughout the series. He's lost, confused, angry, and wishes he could change many of the things in his life that he doesn't understand. He is, for lack of a better term, a home base, for which the audience can return to in this time of insanity in his life, and to be safe, to continue using the baseball metaphor. Naota, and by extension, the adolescent audience allegory, are thrown into progressively larger conflicts throughout the series. Starting relatively small, being dragged along, by accident, by his all-powerful space pirate-possessed robot butler to fight a small hand-shaped robot, and concluding on a grand scale, all the way up to participating in a battle in which an all-powerful space pirate god inhabits his body and helps him stop a multi-planetary evil organization bent on flattening the Earth for their own devious end, and falling in love and admitting it at the same time. However, in all this turmoil, Naota and the audience are never left behind. Chances are that we, as the audience, were very confused as to what the heck was happening on screen. By having Naota be just as confused as we are, it tells the audience, it's okay not to get everything that's going on around you. Shoot, the main character in his own show doesn't even understand what's happening around him.
Although I don't think I could have put it into words at the time, now I understand in my mid-20s. I understand why I felt that message so incredibly comforting. I was worried that I was going to be left behind. Everyone was growing older and seemingly more mature, and it felt like I needed to keep up or be left behind, whether I was ready to or not. Just as I was being dragged forward into this big scary world of my regrettably awkward teenage years, Nauta had been dragged into his teenage years and massive alien robot battles, but he never lost who he was. You see, with other anime that were popular at the time, Dragon Ball Z, Yu Yu Hakusho, Rurouni Kenshin, the main characters were always in control and had a perfect response to any situation. They were powerful, knowledgeable, and above all, competent. While this is a fun, escapist fantasy at the time, none of them really made me feel any better about myself, nor did I expect them to, because I didn't know media could do that. In comes Nauta, being constantly dragged into different and awful situations and being genuinely pissed and terrified about it, like any preteen would. He was weak, angry, terrified to act, and above all, usually, incompetent, in even the most dangerous situation that he's put in. That is, until finally, episode 4 rolls around. He starts to overcome, finally. After being dragged from one encounter to another, spending the better part of 4 episodes whining and merely being a conduit for which the show flows around, he is forced to act. Full Swing is both the audience and Nauta's reminder the fact that you have to make what you want out of life. If you don't like how things are currently progressing, then you have to take the initiative and swing the bat. Yeah, sure, some people might set you up as perfectly as they can for you to hit the pitch, but at the end of the day, you have to swing the bat yourself. No one else can do it for you. Haruko perfectly distills this when she says,
"Anyway, nothing can happen till you swing the bat."
This phrase has stuck with me in the 14 years since I first heard it, and I think it's because it's exactly what I needed to hear at the time. I needed to take control of my life, and this is why the prospect of my teenage years was so frightening. The monsters that I had to deal with, that we all had to deal with, were growing larger and larger, and we could no longer hide behind our childhood innocence and just ignore them. The time had come to swing the bat, and it was way sooner than we were all expecting. And we didn't know if we'd hit the ball, strike out, or what, but we knew we had to swing. In retrospect, I think this may all just be blown way out of proportion. Compared to our current concerns and problems, things didn't seem so bad. But in our waning childhood, we began to realize that there were much larger issues out there to concern ourselves with. However, we still only had our childish mindsets with which to comprehend them. Every problem seemed to be an insurmountable mountain to climb while standing in front of it. Only after did we realize that we generally had the capabilities to make it through any problems, and when looking back, it was clear that we were making mountains out of molehills. But I think that's what makes Fooly Cooly so special. It manages to encapsulate that feeling perfectly. Every issue that Nauta faces seems to be a life and death struggle, which in-universe they are. But whether or not he realizes it, he always has the tools necessary to climb that mountain, and soon realize that it was a molehill the whole time.